I think that we should be proud of where we've come in the last 8 or 10 years. We have a long way to go, and we have some urgency to that because of the number of Canadians that are going to be dying over the next 20 years because we're an aging society. But we've had some wins. We have had some wins around interdisciplinary education. We've had the Pallium Project, which did the LEAP training, which was primary healthcare training program. We had the FPEC Project, which is the Educating Future Physicians in Palliative and End-of-Life Care, that my organization co-coordinated, where we actually got into all 17 medical schools, and they're doing palliative care training with family physicians, so that was exciting. We're doing work with nurses and social workers. So, you know, some of those pieces are good, but we're just hitting the tip of the iceberg of the number of health human resource people that we really need to reach out to. So that was a win. In advocacy and access to hospice palliative care, we've had, we've gone to people recognize the term a little bit more. We've gone from, you know, what we estimated 10 years ago to be 5 to 10% coverage to what CAHI is saying is somewhere between 16 and 35% coverage. So we are doing much better. The challenges are that we still seem to be serving mostly the cancer patients, and, you know, we need to challenge ourselves much further on that, that area. In regards to awareness, I think Canadians are starting to know a little bit more about end of life, and I think that we're seeing that Canadians are talking a little bit more about end of life and hospice palliative care, which is exciting. But we've decided that to get Canadians to talk more about it, we need to look at advanced care planning. So that's our new sort of initiative. But we have seen an improvement. So I think overall, we're quite happy where we've come from. You know, there's lots of things that we need to do better. We need to integrate hospice and palliative care into the healthcare system much better than it is. We need to look at comprehensiveness. We need to look at a collaborative approach with other healthcare providers. So often we hear stories of people that are in the cancer field, and they're getting to the end of their life, and nobody's even told them that, and they've not been referred. And we get, you know, the stays in hospice beds can be, you know, 12 days or 10 days or shorter than that, and that might have been their first interaction with the hospice and palliative care field, which just is, we have so much to offer that we need to look at early referrals. If you were to ask somebody working in the field, I think they'd give you a slightly different answer to that, but the challenges are all around access and being able to get these services.